To be content is to be satisfied with what you have until otherwise. Hi, my name is Ronnie Rock from Who Me Be a Leader, and today I want to talk to you about a subject that's hard for us to do because we're always striving to get better, to do better, to want more, and so it's difficult for us to be content. Matter of fact, Paul said it best that he learned to be content based on Philippians chapter 4, and we're going to get to that later. But I want to talk to you today about how do we learn to be content, because it is a learned process. It's not something that we inherit from our parents. It's a learned process. We have to learn to be satisfied with what we have, and today that's what we're going to get into, because very excited about what God is doing here with Who May Be a Leader and the topics that he's given to me, because it's relevant for today, because we're people that store up things and we're never content with what we have. And so God is telling us that it has to be a point that we be content. Matter of fact, in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33, he said, "But seek first the kingdom and his righteousness, and then all the things will be added to you." He say, seek the kingdom first. God is wanting us to make him first in our life. And then he say those things that we want and sometimes desire, that he would give them to us. Let me read something to you. It said, "The Christian life is a broad road of happiness, joy, peace, blessing, success, sufficiency, and contentment. But ironically gained by choosing the narrow road of surrender, obedience, self-denial, self-sacrifice, and truth." One of the things we got to understand is this: the only way we're going to be content is, first of all, we're going to have to go through God, because we are some people that worry. Matter of fact, in Matthew chapter 6, it talks about, why do we worry about what we're going to eat or drink or what's going to happen? Because it's a sin for us to worry, and we are some worrying people. Now, the world tell you, if you want to be happy, it tell you, hey, get a better job, live in a better home, get a new car, get a, it's always talking about material things to get. But God wants us to be at peace with him, and we gain peace only through him. Now, the world can give you peace, but it's not like the peace that you're going to have with God when it's based on Philippians chapter 4. He say, "And the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your heart and your mind." The thing about it is, God is saying for us to be happy, first and foremost, we have to surrender ourselves. Now, when I look into Matthew chapter 16, it talks about that he who willing to lose his life will find it. Now, we all grow up with a life that we want to have, things that we want to do. And sometimes we get sidetracked with doing what God has called us to do. The thing about it is, if you willing to lose that life that you set up for yourself, because everything that we have belongs to God, and we should carry it loosely. And anytime you go before his throne, you should go before it with your hands open in case God want to take something out of it. Because remember, we was bought and paid for with a ransom, Jesus. That's why Jesus hung on the cross. So we really belong to him. Matter of fact, 1 Timothy says that we are his workmanship, created to do his work. And so when it says in Matthew chapter 16, verse 25, it says, "For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it." Remember, he said, "For my sake." When we do anything for God, matter of fact, 1 Peter tells us, even when we're suffering unjustly, if we're doing it for God's sake, he said we're going to find favor with him. So God has all the basics covered when it comes down to us in having a relationship with him. That's the whole purpose in Jesus dying on the cross and coming to walk here on earth, so he can experience the thing that we might experience. So anytime the world tells you something, it's going to always contradict what it is that God said. Now, Paul says it's a learned process to be content. Because the fact is that we don't want to be content. And we always want things, we always seeking things. And God is saying that we need to be content until the situation change. But sometimes you got to understand, God may not change the situation. So therefore, You have to have a mind change. Romans chapter 12 tells us to do not become conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of the mind. And we got to remember that 1 Timothy said, 6:6, he said, for the fact is that we came here with nothing, and therefore we are leave with nothing. Matter of fact, let's read that, because I want you to get the full, I want you to get the full logist of what he's saying, what Timothy is saying. And in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 6, he says, but godliness actually is a means of great gain when accompanied by contentment, for we have brought nothing into the world, and we cannot take anything with us either. And see, sometimes what happens is when we are not content as people and we go seeking and chase after money. Matter of fact, he would tell us in Hebrews chapter 5, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5, he say, keep your character free from the love of money, because money will make you not be content. If you're a money chaser, then you, a lot of times, you're not going to be content. Look what he said. He said, when he said, we haven't brought anything into the world, we cannot take anything. He said, but those who want to get rich fall into temptation and a snare and many foolish and harmful desires, which plunge men into ruin and destruction. He's saying what happened is when you chasing things, it can be money or it can be something else, but when you so desire that thing to where you can't let it go and you can't be content until you have it, it can plunge you into ruins and destruction. So we need to think about that, man, because a lot of times when we get plunged into ruin and destruction, we taking our family down with us, and we don't want to do that. Let me read something else. Often men cling to some selfish ambitions that is at odds with leading surrendered lives. A lot of times the things that we're doing, man, it contradicts what it is that God wants us to do. He wants us to surrender. So sometimes we have those jobs that won't allow us to surrender. We have personal issues that won't allow us to surrender. And the fact is that sometimes we have hobbies that won't allow us to surrender. And God wants us totally surrender. Remember, they said a commitment means that sometimes you're still in control. But when you totally surrender, you're giving God control. So, man, I want you to think about that. And it's three things I want you to look at. If you are not content where you are now, then you won't be content where you're going. See, a lot of times we're trying to leave a place or leave something because we don't like it and we can't be content, whether it be in a marriage, in a relationship, or a job. We're trying to leave it. Just know one thing, wherever you're going, you're not going to be content if you're not content at the place where you're at. And then not only that, God offer contentment in our circumstances, not escaping from our circumstances. James talks about that, because the fact is that he say, don't be surprised when you endure various trials and tribulation. Sometimes God don't change the situation, but he offer contentment in the situation. And I want to challenge you to read that, James 1:9-11. And then not only that, the great secret to contentment is to get what you want, but wanting what you get. The greatest secret to contentment is getting what you want, but wanting what you get. Contentment, you gotta be content in whatever situation you find yourself until God chooses to change up your situation. Know one thing, sometimes he don't choose to change the situation. He just chooses to change your mind if you surrender to him, because it's a tough thing to be content, because that's why the scripture tells us that we have to learn it. And the way to learn it, you have to practice it. Hey, thank you for this segment. Hey, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, a life unexamined is a life worth not living. God bless you.